I wanted to move to the portfolio of environment now. Tanya Plibersek trying to get her nature positive bill through the Senate, with the PM appearing to step in to make sure there's no climate trigger in any sort of deal with the Greens. But you've said last week, while the government has made concessions, it hasn't gone far enough. What do you want from the government on this?
Well, there's a range of things here, Andrew. I mean, just as a backdrop to all of this, the government promised that by the end of last year, we would have a full replacement for the current environmental approval laws in our parliament. We don't. It's nearly the end of 2024, and all we have are these laws for a new green bureaucracy. That would have been a good start, but the boats sailed on that. So what we're looking for, of course, are some of the things the PM has already flagged to provide greater certainty to businesses. But, you know, I want to see things like the water trigger reversed. They did a deal with the Greens to insert a water trigger into their decision-making processes. That's something I'd love to see. I'd love to see the government commit to ensure that native forestry can continue to operate in this country. It's a proud and sustainable industry. I want to see a commitment from the government that if they're re-elected, even in partnership with the Greens, they will not in any way wind back the capacity for that industry to do what it does. We'd love to see timeframes reduced for assessments. They talk a big game there, but they've not delivered. So they're some of the things we've been asking for. There are a range of technical amendments. There is a long way to go in these discussions. And the alarming thing, though, is on this, Andrew, they continue to talk with the Greens. And you can do a deal with the Coalition or you can do a deal with the Greens. They are incredibly divergent pathways. Where's the government's conviction on this? Which one are they going to back? Is it just about getting a bill through no matter what, or is it about doing the right thing by our country?
You tried to get a disallowance motion up to overturn Tanya Plibersek's decision on the tailings dam at the Blaney mine, and you were unsuccessful. Where to from here on this issue?
Well, it was disappointing. It was only a narrow defeat too, by the way. It's in our national interest to get this mine up. The mine was blocked for spurious yet unexplained reasons by the minister. We've got a private senator's bill before the parliament to override this decision. And, you know, we're not going to let this one go. The minister has nowhere to go on this issue. The local Aboriginal Land Council say it was the wrong decision. The New South Wales Labor Premier says it was the wrong decision. Her own department says it was the wrong decision. So why are we here? And why is the government digging in? So we've got our bill before the parliament. We commence debate on that. When it comes to a vote, Labor senators and other crossbenchers will have the opportunity to do the right thing by our country, by the people of Blaney, and, of course, the resources sector, who look at this decision and go, well, why would you invest in Australia? And they can vote for our bill and back in investment and good measures that will actually grow our economy.
Just finally, as I spoke to the Treasurer about, big monthly inflation figure out this week. The markets think it could even come in under 3. If it does, will this prove the government's been on the right track with the narrow path? And do you think we should see a rate cut this year?
Well, I'd love to see a rate cut along with every other mortgage holder out there. I mean, I think that we need to see that happen. The RBA are constrained by the circumstances they're dealt, and those circumstances are dictated by government spending and government policy. So I'd love to see, despite the fact that the Treasurer, every time that there is no rate cut or if there has been a rate increase, it's everyone else's fault, the RBA oversees factors at play here. I'm sure he'll take credit if there is a rate reduction. But honestly, I've seen no change in policy that has enabled the RBA to deal with the inflationary pressures. Inflation, last check, was not within the target band. Other countries where, of course, rates are now decreasing, it is within the target band. Government have done nothing about getting their spending under control. And, you know, of course, they're slow off the mark when it comes to managing immigration, which is, of course, contributing to inflation. So I'd love to see the cut. I'm no economist, but I'll believe it when I see it if one does come.
Jonathon Duniam, thanks for your time.
Thanks, Andrew.